all my lovely Vidyashreens. How are you all? I hope you all are stay safe and healthy at home. Students, I'm your SST teacher, and today we are going to revise our chapter 1, Mapping the Earth. What is mapping? Mapping the Earth is actually diagrammatic representation of Earth or its part. And today we are going to revise our chapter, Mapping the Earth. In this chapter, we are going to read about globe, map, types of maps, elements of map, and after all these terms, we are going to compare that what is the difference between maps and globes. Okay, students? So, let's get started. So, our first term, globe. Our first ancient globe was invented by a French cartographer whose name was Martin Behm in 1942, and he named that ancient globe as Erdäpfel, which means earth apple. Now, why does earth apple? Because it looks like the earth only. It is spherical representation of earth, means the ball like representation of earth, and it is the true model of earth because it shows the continents, the countries in an actual size, the size of ocean, seas, all things in actual size. But there are some disadvantages of globe as well. First disadvantage is that it is not easy to carry around, and we cannot see or we cannot watch the more details on a globe at a time. Maps. Map is the representation of earth on flat surface like paper, board, wall, etc. It is very easy to carry around, and it is very convenient for all the people to carry around. And there are three types of maps. Now, what are the three types of maps? Let me show you. As we had already discussed that we have three main kinds of map, that is physical, political, and thematic map. First of all, we will discuss about the political map. What is political map? Political map is actually the map that shows the boundaries of the different states and the countries. Okay, and it also shows the states and capitals within it. Second is our physical map. As the name suggests, it shows us the physical features of the earth. Now, what are the physical features? For example, rivers, lakes, mountains, deserts, ocean, etc. Everything that is physical feature of the earth, we show all these physical features of the earth in the second type of map, that is physical map. Third type of map, that is thematic map. Thematic map, as the name suggests, it is theme based map. I can revise the things like this. Theme based map. Now, these maps can show the specific theme. For example, I want to show the rainfall of an area. So, I will do that thing in the thematic map. Now, what the thematic map shows? Thematic map shows the climate, rainfall, forest, vegetation, temperature, etc. of a particular place or of a particular country. Okay, students, elements of map. Now, what are elements of map? Elements of map are actually the things that make it easy to read a map. Now, what are the elements of map? First is title. As the name suggests, it tells us about the type of the map or the area covered by the map. Second is orientation. Now, what is orientation? It tells us about the four major cardinal direction, that where the four major cardinal directions are in the map. And you have probably seen the north is always there at the top of the map like this, right? Next is symbols. Symbols are actually the signs and the pictures that are used to represent the things from the real world. For example, PS is used for police station. Right? P
O is used for post office. These are the symbols. And why, how I know that PS is police station and PO is post office? So these symbols are actually defined by the keys or legend. That tells us about all the symbols that which are meant for the reading of map. And next is, and the last is scale. Now, what is scale? Scale is actually the representation of the distance, right? This scale, right? In this manner, map is also having the scale. On the map, have you ever seen that the distance, it shows the distance about the actual world and the distance on the map. So what do we mean by scale now? Scale is actually the relationship or the ratio between the distance of the map on the map or the distance in the real world. For example, if some map is showing the scale of the map as 1:100, here we mean that on the map 1 centimeter will be equal to 1 meter on the actual world. Okay, we have one linear scale or the graphic scale also. That scale is actually a line segment which is divided into different distances. That is known as the linear scale. That's all for today's revision. I hope you understand for our first chapter. Now get ready for your first assignment or first test of yours. Best of luck.